Hello everyone. Today our topic is ecology, which is from the subject Environment Science, Unit 2. First of all, what is ecology? Ecology, the word originated from the Greek origin, that is oikos, which means household in Greek, and logos, which means study of. So together it is ecology, that is the study of the household. The study of the house or the environment in which we live is known as ecology. What is ecology? Actually, it is a scientific study of the interaction between the organisms and their environment, focusing on the energy transfers. Ecology is the science of relationship. What do you mean by environment? Anything that surrounds us is known as our environment. The environment is mainly made up of two factors, that is biotic factor or living organism inhibiting the earth, and the abiotic factors, that is non-living parts of the environment, that is temperature, soil, light, moisture, air, currents, etc. Now the whole ecology is divided like this, means organism is the least class, then comes the population, then the community, then the ecosystem, and then the biosphere. We learn each in detail. What is organism? An organism is a unicellular or multicellular form exhibiting all the characteristics of a life and individual. It is an individual organism. It is an individual class, that is an organism. The lowest level of organization is the organism. Now what is population? Population, a group of organisms of one species living in the same place at the same time and that interbreed to produce fertile offsprings are known as the population. They compete with each other for resources such as food, mates, shelters, etc. Now what is a community? Community is several interacting population that inhibit a common environment and are interdependent. They are what? Several interbreeding population that live together. And what is ecosystem? The populations in a community and the abiotic factors, that is the temperature, light, etc., with which they interact. For example, marine ecosystem, terrestrial ecosystem. Terrestrial means on land, marine means on water. So, biosphere. Life supporting portions of the earth composed of air, land, fresh water and salt water is known as biosphere. It is the highest level of the organization. Now, scope of ecology and its relation to the other divisions of science. Ecology is an interdisciplinary field that includes biology and earth science. Ecology is closely related to the physiology, evolutionary biology, genetics and ethology. An understanding of how the biodiversity affects the ecological function is an important focus area in ecological studies. Now, scope of ecology. Ecology can be studied at several levels, from proteins and nucleic acid, that is in biochemistry and molecular biology, in cells, that is in cell biology, organism, that is in botany means plants, zoology means study of animals, and in other similar disciplines. And finally, the level of populations, communities and ecosystems, which are the subject of ecology. Because of its focus on the broadest level of life and on interrelationship between living beings and their environment, ecology draws heavily on the other branches of science such as geology, geography, meteorology, pedology, chemistry and physics as well. Now what is otocology and syncology? Otocology and syncology are the two main branches of ecology. Otocology refers to the study of relationship between an individual species and the environment, while syncology refers to the study of relationship between communities and the environment. Syncology means the study of structure, nature, organization and development of the plant communities. Now, importance of ecology. Since all of us live in a natural or partly natural ecosystem, then considerable pressure can be derived from studying the environment around us. Human economies are based on the explanation and management of the nature. Applied ecology is used every day in forestry, forensic science, fisheries, range management, agriculture, and soon to provide us with food and fiber we need. Human societies can often be understood very clearly from an ecological perspective as we study, for example, the population dynamics, that is the demography of our own species, the food and the fossil flowing through the society. humans also appear to be changing the nature in many ways, the environment in many ways. Thus, ecology can be helpful in understanding what these changes might for various ecosystems and how we might intervene either in human economies or in nature to try to migrate one or others and alter these changes. There are many professional ecologists who believe that these apparent changes from human activities have the potential to generate enormous harm to both natural ecosystem as well as the human economies. Now, types of ecosystem. There are many types of ecosystem on the earth, but basically they can be divided into two parts, that is the terrestrial and the aquatic ecosystem. In aquatic ecosystem, they are also divided into freshwater ecosystem and ocean ecosystem. Now, what is an habitat or niche? Niche is the role of a species play in a community, its total way of life. And what is habitat? The place in which a species or the organism lives out its life is known as its habitat. A niche is determined by the tolerance, limitations of an organism or the limiting factors. Limiting factors are what? Any biotic or abiotic factor that restricts the extension of the organism in a specific environment is known as the limiting factors. Now, guild ecology. A guild is any group of species that exploits the same resources, matlab means the temperature, the water, often in a related ways. The name guild emphasizes the fact that these groups are like the association of the craftsmen who employ similar techniques in plying their trade. They often are composed of groups of closely related species that all arose from the common ancestors, and they exploit resources in the similar way as the result of their shared ancestry. Now, ecological adaptation. What are adaptation? All living things change to fit the environment. These are known as their adaptation. That is the characteristics of their life. Now, what are adaptation? Adaptation is an inherited characteristic that helps an organism to survive long enough to reproduce more successfully in its changing environment, and can either be structural or behavioral. Now, adaptation are mainly classified or separated into two parts, that is the physical, which can also be known as structural, and the behavioral adaptation. Now, first of all, we learn the structural adaptation. Definition is that actual body part of the or the coloration of the animal or the organism that helps an organism to survive in their environment. Example, camouflage, that is coloration, mimicry, bent hind lips, sharp teeth and claws, and body structures. This is the some of the structural adaptation, like the teeth of the carnivorous. Now, behavioral adaptation. Ways an organism act to help them survive in their environment is known as the behavioral adaptation. Example is migration, hibernation, warning calls, mating, dances, hunting in packs, etc. Now, types of structural adaptation, that is coloration. Blending in with the environment for the protection from the predators or to help or sneak up on prey. Mainly it is to obtain the food. As you can see, the lion, they have a coloration that is similar to the grassland in which they live, so they can hunt properly. Now, mimicry, that is copying a behavior or appearance. As you can see, many of the poisonous butterflies, they act as if they are non-poisonous. They mimic the other organism. As you can see, a butterfly is mimicking as if it is an owl, so that it can be rescued from its enemies. It is used for protection or for obtaining food and protection. Bent hind lips, prey can run fast to escape, and predators can run faster to catch the prey. This is one of the structural adaptation. It is used for protection and locomotion. Now, types of structural adaptation are teeth. Some of the teeth of herbivorous and carnivorous are different, and they are according to their food type. Sharp teeth is mainly adapted for cutting of the meat eaters. Now, types of structural adaptation, that is body structure. For prey, the eyes are on both the sides, so they can detect their predator and can be rescued from them. And predator, the eye facing forward to find the prey. Their eyes are very sharp, so they can find their prey properly. For example, owl, so they can see their prey, that is the mouse, etc., and leopard. Now we have been looking at the structural adaptation of the animal, adaptations on the body, but the animals can also have behavioral adaptation. This type of adaptation cannot be seen on the body. It is how they behave and the way an animal reacts or behaves in a certain situation, in other words, instincts. Now first of all is migration. What is migration? Seasonal or periodic movement of animals in response to changes in climate or food availability or to ensure reproduction. Means they migrate from one area to the other. For example, geese, whales, salmon, monarch butterflies, etc. Migration most commonly involves the movement of one area to the other and again back. Second is the hibernation. What is hibernation? Adaptive winter survival techniques where animal becomes inactive and all the body processes slow down. Means they go to sleep for like 6 months during the winter season. For example, bears, chipmunks, squirrel bats, etc. Now living in a group. Many animals tend to live in the group so that more eyes in a group to watch out for prey, predators and protection. For example, fish, deer, buffaloes, etc. Now behavioral adaptation. The fourth one is tool use. Any object manipulated by an animal in order to perform a specific task is known as the tool use. As you can see, to make nest, they use a simple tool, etc. Playing dead. Many of the animals, they act as if they are dead. By pretending that they are dead, some animals escape bodily harm from snakes and etc. Calling. Communication between animals is used as a behavioral adaptation. Threatening gestures, that is, scares the potential predators. As you can see, some of the snakes, they threaten the predators. Plant adaptation. All living things adapt is a characteristic of life. All six kingdoms adapt. Animals are not the only organisms to adapt. Structural, there are plants also adapt to their environment. Structures, adaptation of the body. Hold fast, empty space for water storage, catch animals for minerals, tallness, hardiness, thorns, flexibility, flotation devices are some of the structures. Seeds, what are seeds? All seeds are baby plants. They have adaptation to better and able to survive long enough to plant itself and grow. Protection, for protection they have parts like thorns, bad taste, poison, coloration, spikes, etc. For obtaining food, all plants do photosynthesis. What is photosynthesis? They make glucose, their own food from sunlight and water. So plant behaviorals, plants do not only have structural behavior, but they also have behavioral adaptations that help them to survive in the environment. Tropism is one of them. That is the movement of the plants towards any stimulus. Towards is called positive stimulus, away is called negative stimulus. Phototropism, when a plant senses light and the shoots grow towards the light source. This is the positive tropism, means a plant grow towards the light. Because the plant is growing towards the stimulus, it is known as the positive stimulus. As you get, when the growth of the plant changes in response to the direction of gravity, shoots have a negative gravitotropism because they grow in the opposite direction of the force of gravity. Roots mostly have positive gravity because they grow towards the force of the gravity. Roots have positive stimulus towards the gravitational force. This is the animation of how the root, they tend to be positive gravitotropism, and the shoot for the light, they grow towards the negative. They have negative gravitotropism. They grow towards the light. Dormancy, it is a state of rest or inactivity. Many plants go dormant in the winter season. Now, adaptation. So, adaptation, first of all, we look at the desert adaptation. Animal adaptation to the desert. Water can be stored by the animal in fatty deposits in their tails and other tissue. Minimizes loss of water out of skin, from urine and feces, and from breathing through various means, etc. The reduction wasn't enough when it's time to get rid of the body heat by evaporation. Long appendages or small bodies that radiate heat. Camel is the best desert animal that we can see. It has some of the adaptation like hump, two rows of long eyelashes, hair in ears, nostrils that can be closed, long legs, thick leathery patches, broad and flat leathery pads, wool or fur. These are some of the adaptations. Common adaptations seen in desert plants are they have enhanced cuticle away waxy covering, which prevents water loss. Long vertical roots enable a plant to reach water sources beneath the soil. Shallow radial roots, which extend horizontally, which maximizes the water absorption at the surface. Trichomes, hair-like projections that create a thick boundary layer, which deflects the heat as well as the infrared radiation. Spines and hairs, which discourage herbivorous and increases boundary layer effects. Plant adaptations to the desert are: water can be stored in roots, stem, etc. They tend to store water. Many desert plants can tolerate great losses of water from their body. This can be done by staying out of the sun. Their leaves are converted into thorns, so they have less loss of water through transpiration. And their leaves vertically minimize the surface area directly hit by the sun, by insulation, by shining surface that reflects the light, etc. So, small and narrow leaves, which decreases heating from the sun, rotating leaves, which enable the plants to orient its leaves from the maximum exposure to the sun. Now, aquatic ecosystem, let's see what is there. When animals live in water, they must have special adaptation so that they can live in water. The more time an animal spends in water, the more adaptation the animal will have for the aquatic life. Streamlined body reduces friction when the animal moves through the water. Smooth, mostly furless they are. They have webbed feet so that they can swim easily. They have long legs and necks that keep the bodies of these aquatic birds that are on the coastal regions out of the water, and are thin, light and easy to move. And their long neck help the birds to reach the water or below for the food, that is the fish. They can hunt the fish easily. Flippers are providing large surface for the pushing against the water and act like paddles. Paddles are the rows that the boats use. Eye is positioned on the top of the head, allowing the animals to hide almost fully submerged in water and still detect predators or prey above the water. Nostrils are positioned near the top of the head, allow the animals to come to the surface and breathe. Nostrils close when the animals goes under the water. Transparent eyelids they have so that their eyes can have, they can swim easily and their eyes are protected. Flattened tails also serve as the paddles. As you can see here, the streamlined body help them to swim, and their blowholes help them to breathe. And they have counter shading that decrease their visibility. And these are the few parts of the aquatic animal, that is the fish, their adaptation so that they can live in water. Now, aquatic adaptation in plants, that is the presence of little or no mechanical strength tissue in stems and leaf petioles. If these plants are removed from the water, they are hanging limply. They don't have strength as the terrestrial plants. They are normally supported by the water around them. The submerged plants lack external protective tissue because they don't have to limit their water loss. So they don't have any waxing covering or the outer surface covering, so the water can be water cannot be lost like that. All the surface of the cell appears to be able to absorb water, nutrients, dissolved gases directly from the surrounding water. Roots, which mainly play an important role in the absorption of nutrients and water from the substance, are also reduced, and their main function is only anchorage. Many species have different specialized leaf shapes, and they have air-filled cavity that extend through the leaf and the stem of the aquatic plants and provide an internal atmosphere, giving them an internal air-filled cavities, their own personal oxygen source. This is the water hyacinth. As you can see, the roots are very small, and they have, as I said, they have hollow stem that help them for oxygen transport. Now, arboreal adaptation. Arboreal means any plant or animals that live in among the trees. Arboreal locomotion is the locomotion of the animals in trees. In habitats in which trees are present, animals have evolved to move in them. Some animals may only scale trees occasionally, while others are exclusively arboreal, means they live on tree alone. These habitats pose numerous mechanical challenges to the animals moving across them, leading them to a variety of anatomical and physiological adaptation. That is, one is limb length. Arboreal animals frequently have elongated limbs, means long limbs that help them to cross the gaps and reach the fruits that is on the trees, and they can give them firmness to support them, and in some cases they help them to transport from one branch to other. They have prehensile tail. Many arboreal species such as tree porcupines and chameleons, they use prehensile tail to grasp the branches. In spider monkeys, the tip of the tail has either a bare patch or adhesive pad, which provides an increased friction. Claws can be used to interact with the rough substrate, means they give them friction so that they can be attached to the trees. Orient the one direction of the forces that an animal applies. This is what allows the squirrels to climb trees and that are so large to be essentially flat from the perspective of such small animals. They have reversible feet also, that is to control especially down large diameter branches. Some arboreal animals, to stay on the trees, they need to have like squirrels, they have highly mobile ankle joints that permit the rotating the foot into a reverse posture. This allows the claws to hook into the rough surface of the bark, opposing the force of the gravity. This is the diagram of the reversible foot. Small size provides many advantages to the arboreal species, such as increasing the relative size of the branches to the animals, lower center of masses, increased stability, lower masses, and the ability to move through the cluttered habitat. Hanging under the perches, some species of primate, bat, and other species of sloth achieve a passive stability by hanging beneath the branch. Arboreal plants are those plants that live on trees. Best example is the orchid. Such plants have adaptation in order to survive their lofty environment. One is parasitism, that these animals, these plants depend on the trees itself for their food, water, etc. One example is mistletoe. Root adaptation, the arboreal plants develop modification allowing them to capture and store water. These roots of the species are exposed to the air and susceptible to drying out and help them to retain water. Leaf adaptation, many arboreal plants growing directly on the ground have green chlorophyll filled leaves that use sunlight to create their food. Some plants that grow on trunks have no green leaves but have chlorophyll in their exposed roots clinging to the tree's bark. Other arboreal plants have no leaves at all and depends on the symbiotic relationship with the fungus living in their roots for food. Flower adaptation, mainly arboreal plants have very attractive flowers, like orchid flowers are one of the example. They adapted it for the survival in different growing condition and in presence of different pollinators. The color, the structure are evolved to attract specific pollinators unique to the environment. Thank you.